Hi, my name is Andrei Osechuk. I welcome you to another training on Analysis Workspace. Today I want to give you an advice about how you may want to visualize data in your dashboards. The scenario that I want to start with is the following. I want to prepare a dashboard to compare marketing channels' performance. And just for this example, I will be using two KPIs. One KPI is the bounce rate, another one is the revenue or sales volume. In real life, this can be any type of metric, any type of KPI. It's very often in my practice when I see such a visualization in dashboards, and yes, we can understand which marketing channels have higher or lower values. However, what will be the next action? To answer this question, we need more context. We need to understand whether this or that marketing channel performs better or worse in comparison to average on our website. For example, here we can see that the average somewhere in between 0 and 80%, but we don't know where it is. And this is why we don't know where to start with and whether, for example, the display channel that shows the bounce rate higher than 20% is more or less good or bad result. This is again just for example purposes, but in your case there may be other dimensions with even more values. In order to understand where you need to focus on, you need to compare these values with the average. But the average doesn't exist on this diagram. This is why this is quite complicated. Another thing that I want to mention here, I want to share this with my colleagues. And some of my colleagues do not work with web analytics at all. They may work with Microsoft Excel. Some of them work with business intelligence platforms. And as you know, in different platforms and in different reports and analyses, there may be different best practices as to what color to use for which type of diagrams and for which type of values. And that's very common when green light is used to show something positive or neutral. And at the same time, the green color is almost never used when you want to show a negative result or a bad result. And for those who will work with this dashboard, this may be also not so clear because maybe they do not fully understand the bounce rate, and this is why they may not understand that the higher the value is, the worse the situation is. But we know it. And would it be better if those dimensions or those elements in the dimension that have a higher value, the highest values, will be highlighted with red, while those which have a lower value, they would be highlighted with green? And this is something that I would recommend you to consider. And now I want to show you a few examples of how I would rebuild this diagram so that it will have more context. I will open these two diagrams that have a comparison of marketing channels by bounce rate. And I hope you can already recognize that this is a little bit easier to understand, to interpret the data. Because now we have first different colors. Those elements that have a high bounce rate are highlighted with purple, which is very close to red color. And those channels that have a lower bounce rate in comparison to the average are highlighted with green. In other words, this is a healthy situation. And the third diagram shows you pretty much the same, but here I just wanted to show you that this diagram can also be prepared with vertical bars. So now compare the left chart with the two charts on the right and think about what will be easier to interpret, what will be more efficient way to visualize the data. I think that these two charts on the right are more actionable, which is very important for any type of the dashboard or even project that you share with your colleagues. So this bounce rate metric, again, is just for example. You can use any type of metric. It can be your conversion rate, it can be your lead closure rate, any type of macro and micro conversion rates. Now let's have a look at the next KPI, which is in my case revenue or sales volume. And again, the situation is pretty much the same. We understand which marketing channels bring the highest volume of sales, but we don't understand what is the average. We can't understand how to compare these channels. And you can see that the first channel has a much higher value. So now the question is, what is the average? So now think about, if you get such a dashboard, what would be your interpretation of this data? What marketing channels, based on your opinion, perform better or worse than the average? Just think about this couple of seconds. And now I'm going to show you the same type of visualizations, but for the revenue metric, and compare this with what you decided. So the real situation is that the average is somewhere where display channel is. And you can see that paid search and email marketing actually show quite positive value in terms of sales volume. Yes, they bring much less than the first channel, but anyway, this is higher than average. And again, the interpretation of this much easier with this type of diagram, because now you can see what is in the red zone, what is in the green zone. And this can be a universal approach for any type of the metric, which is in absolute numbers. Number of orders, number of unique visitors, average selling price, etc., etc., etc. You can work with any type of dimensions, with any type of metrics. So this is what I wanted to show you. If you want to learn how to create such charts, visualizations, you're very welcome to enroll in the Analysis Workspace Mastery course. You can find the link under this video. This is it for this video episode. Thank you for watching.